Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I wasn't able to post last week, I'm sorry, but I will be going back to my regular schedule now. It was a little hectic, you know, I was working a lot and was not able to film as much as I wanted to. I just want to throw this out there so there's no one in the comments pointing it out, but I have a pimple and I covered it with the Beauty Mark, so real supporters know which one is a real Beauty Mark and which one is not. Anyways, if you are new to my channel, please make sure to turn on your post notifications and comment when you're done. I always give shout outs at the end of my videos. So at the end of this video, I'll be giving shout outs from my other videos. So make sure you keep watching till the end. If you guys are new to my channel, or maybe you haven't seen it yet, but I actually did have a video similar to this topic, but it's not quite exactly that, but it kind of falls under the category of it. The video is the reason why I dropped out of high school. The reason why I dropped out of high school was because I was actually bullied. I don't know why people don't believe me when I say that. I really don't, but I was bullied in high school. I wasn't, you know, picked on, like, I mean, fighting bullied. I was mentally and verbally bullied by mean girls. If you haven't seen the video, you can go watch it. It's titled The Reason I Dropped Out of High School, but I'm just gonna kind of briefly touch on it real quick. So in high school, I was the girl to always address certain things that I felt strongly about. I still am actually the same person. Basically, if someone was talking about me, or if I heard someone was talking about me for whatever reason, I would, you know, address them or ask them, like, you know, what's up, what's the problem? If you have something to say, why don't you just say it to me instead of telling my friends or boyfriend at the time? And, you know, they're gonna tell me, so you might as well just say it to me. I wouldn't say that's the main reason why I was talked about, but that was definitely one reason why people would like to say crap about me. Oh, she's crazy, she starts drama. When actually I didn't even talk to anyone to start drama, so. Like, I stay to myself, but okay. I guess in high school, you're supposed to shut your mouth when people talk about you, and you're just not supposed to address it like adults. Another reason why I was bullied was for my weight. The highest I ever weighed in high school was, I wanna say, 129, 128, and I was a sophomore. I think I was 5 foot still. I've been 5 foot for a very long time. I was called fat. And although it didn't ever bother me because I knew I wasn't fat, it does mess with you mentally. You start to think, like, well, maybe I am, or question it. The main topic that was mostly discussed about me was my relationship at the time. And things were said about me like, oh, he's too good for her, or she's not pretty enough. He's too good for us, and I'm like, he's better looking than me, or we just, you know, what is he doing with her? Those things were said about me. The way I handled it, I just dropped out. That doesn't mean I didn't graduate. I graduated online. I finished high school online. I actually graduated before my class. It was senior year that I removed myself from school and finished online. That's just the way I chose to handle things. I don't regret any of my decisions. I don't wish I stayed. I don't wish I had, like, you know, had the choice to enjoy my senior year, because I actually hated high school the entire time. So there are no regrets. But there are other ways of handling it, as I know that a lot of you guys don't have those kind of options, maybe because you want to experience high school and you want to figure out ways to handle being in those types of certain, you know, situations. Or maybe your parents don't agree with that and they want you to stay in school because maybe they don't understand, or maybe you just don't have a close enough relationship to tell them what's going on, or whatever their circumstance may be. Maybe they don't understand, maybe they don't know what it's like. I have wrote down some ways to avoid being bullied, or how to handle being bullied in high school or middle school or whatever. I hope that it wouldn't go younger than, you know, being in grade school, because that's really, really unfortunate that little kids are that evil nowadays. The first thing is probably way easier said than done. But I have to say it because it's true. Ignore. And I say ignore even if it's hard, and I know that, you know, people say some mean things. But I say ignore because no one's really worth your energy at the end of the day. And you need to remember that, I'm just gonna say high school, no one is gonna matter once you graduate. And everyone always says that, and people are always like, no, my friends meant this and that. Like, girl or boy, whatever, stop. Like, you're not gonna talk to pretty much none of these people. You'd be lucky if you had that one good friend that stuck by you after high school and, you know, you guys grew up together and shoot, they're your best man or your bridesmaid at your wedding. You're lucky. I'm not saying it's not possible, it's possible, but for the most part, all the irrelevant people who talk bad about you, they're not gonna be in your life, they're not gonna freaking matter. As a matter of fact, the karma is coming their way. Most of those people who are talking are probably gonna end up... No one matters when you graduate. No one. Everyone becomes irrelevant. They're like the gum underneath your shoe or something. Peasants. All the people who have bullied you will get their karma one way or another. And believe me, it does happen. All of the girls who would call me fat, now they're unhealthy or overweight, but they used to talk about all the girls who weren't skinny enough in high school, all the little cheerleaders who used to talk crap about me are now completely out of shape. And it's like, well, the tables have turned. I was never fat though, but I mean, watch who you talk about. You should never wish bad on anybody. Whatever ended up happening to the people who bullied me, you know, I don't take pride in that. I'm just like, What needed to be done was done. But back to what I was saying, karma will definitely come their way. I don't know how, you don't know when, but it will definitely happen because you can't continue throughout life being such a person to other people who are never even done anything or even know you or talk about you, and you expect nothing to happen to you. You think that all that bad energy isn't gonna be reciprocated right back to you at some point in life. It's better to be the bigger person and to ignore it as much as you possibly can. And I'm telling you, I understand that it is very hard to ignore, but not everything is worth your reaction. Actually, sometimes having no reaction is definitely the best reaction. Another option, you could always talk to somebody, whether it's a family member or a friend or even a counselor at school, a school counselor, or a just regular counselor. It's okay to get help. It's okay to talk to somebody. It's okay to talk about your problems. It's not good to hold it all in. Eventually, you're gonna hold it all in, you're gonna bottle up, and your freaking head's gonna spin around and explode. I think that was enough dramatic, right? You get the point, okay? It's not good to hold things in. It's not good to hold things in. Don't do that. Remember that everyone has their own opinion, and although that person's feelings and opinions are not the nicest and they're not making the nicest comments and everything they're saying is mean, understand that you should not feel bad for yourself. You should actually feel bad for them, because it takes so much energy to carry that much hate. Honey, if you're hating me that much, I feel bad for you, because you must be really, really, really miserable to hate everybody you come encounter with for no reason. Like they say, if you ain't got haters, you ain't popping. You ain't got no haters, you ain't popping. Because think about it, something about you is such a force to be reckoned with that another human is picking apart how amazing you are. Taking time out of their life to find anything to say or to do that revolves around you. Shoot, I must be real special then. Another option, to say the least, you could always beat the shit out of them. I'm just kidding. I don't condone violence. But if you talk about my mama, my family, or my man, all I ask is that you keep that same energy when I pull up. Because don't get fucked up. Keep your circle small. Choose wisely with who you decide to give your time to and who you decide to be friends with and open up to, because not all of your friends want you to succeed or to surpass them. You could always be homeschooled, just throwing that out there. It's not the worst idea. I actually loved it. If the bullying continues and goes to social media, I would say stay off social media completely. I would like deactivate whatever. I mean, I had to delete my Facebook and I never went back on Facebook again. I did it like sophomore year and I'll like never go on Facebook again, just because, all those bad memories. If you wanna fight it and you don't wanna stay off social media, you could always disable the comments, make your page private, or block. The block button is your friend. Most importantly, work on being a better you. At the end of the day, what you think of yourself is all that matters. Take whatever steps necessary to continue being great and prospering, whether it's finding a new hobby, surrounding yourself with friends, getting closer to God, or whatever religion anybody who's watching this is, whatever you think is gonna help you, exercise. I love to exercise. That's just my stress reliever. That's my go-to. That's how I, you know, handle most of my problems or when I'm stressed out or overwhelmed. That's what helps me. Draw, vent, write it out. Shoot, start a YouTube channel. Make some videos. Hair, makeup, skateboarding, jump roping, hiking. It really doesn't matter, anything. But find a hobby that you enjoy doing that will benefit you for the future or for the time being. I hope this video helped a little bit. I know I didn't really cover bullying physically. If someone is physically putting your life in danger, you need to talk to a parent, you need to call the police, you need to talk to the teacher, a principal, I don't care. You need to talk to somebody, especially if they're harming you. And self-defense is not a crime, so don't be afraid to, if they are laying their hands on you. Self-defense only though. No, just for no reason, okay? I'm gonna give a couple shout outs for my post notifications. Again, turn on those notifications, okay? It's a bell somewhere on my channel. I have a hard time telling you guys where it's at, but it's on the front page of my channel. Turn on the red bell and comment when you're done, or leave a comment, and I will be shouting you out at the end of my video. Alonzo Jones says, done, shout out to you. Monique has sent, oh, I really don't wanna say it wrong. Monique Cinero said, I subscribed right away and turned on my post notifications as well. Hope to get a shout out. Love you, Danielle, you're so beautiful and love your personality. Thank you, girl, shout out to you. Life and Death, very interesting name. I love you and done, shout out to you, love you too. I'm Just Nia says done, so shout out to you, girl. Thank you for turning on your post notifications. Devin Smothers says done as well, shout out to you. Donovan Clark, I turned on my post notifications, so shout out to you. A-T-Y-N-F-R says been done, glad you added some positive words to any person going through depression. Hopefully we could collab soon. Shout out to you. You know my Instagram, in the link in the bio. Aaliyah Bolden says, done with the check mark. Shout out to you, girl. King Kev says, just done it. Love you so much. I love you too. And shout out to you. Tay2X says, done. So shout out to you as well. Sorry, you guys, there's so many shout outs. Shout out to Victoria Dang. She says, done. She put a bunch of flowers. Shout out to you, girl. Baby Ronnie says, done. Love you. Love you too, Ronnie. Shout out to you. Justin Hill says, shout me out. My birthday's tomorrow. And honestly, that was probably last week. But happy belated birthday. Gaming with Rudy says, done. Shout out to you. Like I said, you guys know what to do for the post notification shout out. If you guys like this video, then please make sure to give me a like. Like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in a- Ooh. You know, I just need to fix my hair. Actually, I'm gonna just start all over because I didn't really like that. If you guys like this video, then please make sure to give me a like. Like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys next time. It's just us, girl. Let me know what's up, girl. What's up, girl? 'Cause I'm gonna throw it down. Beat it up, go down. Beat it up, take it down, 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 down. Beat it up. Let me switch up the tempo. Let me switch up the tempo. Let me switch up the tempo.